this is Miss Knight, and I'm going to tell you about the MCF portion of the Ames Web Plus assessment. First, I'm sure you're all wondering what MCF stands for. It stands for Mental Computation Fluency. That means these are problems you do in your brain. You don't use a pencil and paper to solve these. We want to see what you're able to do in your mind without writing it down. The computation you'll be doing in the MCF is addition and subtraction. We're giving you this test to find out what skills you are good at and what skills you still need to learn. So don't stress too much about the things you don't know. This is a 4-minute test, so please concentrate on the skills that you do know and problems you can solve. I'm going to show you the MCF by practicing some skills with you. So let's go! There's a few things I want you to know before we look at the problems. The first one is that on the MCF, you will be given one practice problem. This problem is not timed, and it's there so that you get familiar with what kind of problems they're going to give you. The next thing you need to know is that when the test starts, you'll be given 2 problems per page. Each problem will have the number sentence at the top, and underneath will be 3 answers that you need to choose from. Lastly, skip counting will be very helpful in this test. Most of the problems here can be solved by skip counting forward or backward from any number. You know how to do that. Let's look at our first example. This is an example of a page you'd see on your computer for the MCF. As you can see, there are 2 problems on the page, separated by a line, and each problem has 3 answers you can choose from. Let's go ahead and practice with the top problem, 56 plus 30. This problem is a good example of how we can use skip counting to help us. We don't need to skip count starting at a 10, a 5, or a 2. We can skip count from any number. So for this problem, we're going to start at 56. Since we're adding 30 to 56, we need to count by tens, because 30 means 3 tens. So we're going to start at 56. We're going to count on our fingers 3 times as we count by tens. Are you ready? Here we go. So starting at 56, now 1 finger, 66, 76, 3rd finger is 86. So our answer is 86. 56 plus 30 is 86. And I see 86 right here. We did it. We got the answer. Skip counting made that problem so easy. We just had to skip count by tens 3 times, and it got us right to our answer. That's great. So let's go on to the next example. I'm sure you'll do just as well with this one. Here's our second example page. This one also has 2 problems, and each problem has 3 choices for answers. This time, let's do the bottom one, 210 minus 100. This problem also requires our skip counting skills, but we're doing subtraction in this one, so we don't skip count forward, we need to skip count backwards. Are you ready to do it with me? We are going to skip count backwards, but we have to figure out what place value to skip count by. I see the problem has 210, but we're subtracting 100. There's no tens in hundreds, so we need to skip count by hundreds. We're starting at 210, skip counting by hundreds, but how many times do we have to skip count backwards? Well, it's only 100, so that means 1 time. So let's go. 210, 110. I see 110 as one of the options for the answers. It's right here. We did it again. Great job. going over all these skills and all this information step by step may seem a little overwhelming right now, but these are all skills you know and already use. We just want to make sure that you use them when you take the MCF. The most important things to remember is that you'll get one practice problem before you start the test. There are two problems on each page, and each problem has three answers to choose from. And remember to use your skip counting. That'll get you through almost every problem. Remember to practice these skills, and you will do great on the MCF. I know you can do it because you already know how. Bye-bye. Thanks for watching. Happy math!